Roland there in 7th position is just climbing back up to them again. So Wackenbauer got that one done just in time, and that's all he needed. Is there's that someone's in the pits? Who's that? Can't quite work that out. It's not one of the top guys. It's it's Siggy Schroen's in the pits there from 7th. He's in 7th. Ostermann is in as well. So what's this? This is lap 16. So maybe actually people are going to be looking at two stopping, because that's just past the half hour mark. I think people were maybe slightly surprised at how the tyres are running there. We've been given information that one stop potentially is the way to go, so we shall see with bated breath. Does that look like Kai and Matt running out onto the grass just for a split second there? But Piccolo still leads from Casa as they continue to entertain us all with a game of cat and mouse. Who will be Tom, who will be Jerry by the end? Who only knows? So Gene T still by himself. He must feel like he's got some kind of stinky smell, because no one's going near him in third position. Thomas Wackenbauer 4, Rowan 5, Roland 6th. That's the battle that's on your screen at the moment. Nick Roland feeling a little bit feisty and wanting to cry himself back up the order. Martin Palm finds himself in 7th. Osterman 8, Carmen Fisher? I've changed it 6. Ooh, text. Who's that? Should we read it out? Oh, maybe not from this person. Hope you had a good Christmas. Oh, naff off. Don't you find that really annoying? Hope you had a good Christmas. Might catch up with you in the new year. Oh, yeah, call yourself a friend. Tosspot. Down into turn one we come. Wackenbauer, Rowan and Roland. It's like when people... I was going to really slag something off then, and I realised I'd do it myself. I'll stop. Say when people don't actually say thanks for my birthday wishes, and they just do a big like for everything, but then everyone does that, it's easier. Nick Roland harrying the back of Sebastian Rowan though. Oh dearie me, this isn't a contact sport. Nick, come back. Brown nosing the wrong people if you want to get into that auto sport. You're not meant to brown nose the car in front as they come sliding around a couple of the corners. And the damage is set very, very high in this mod, so just the slightest of taps can cause all kinds of dramas, as we've seen with people that have looked like they've just gently touched the barriers, and out they go. So a good visual illustration of this mod, the GT3 mod. I'm not sure if it's actually even available for everyone else to get yet, but this is kind of a showcasing event. I've been told that it is still in beta testing. So if we follow R-Factor 2's trend, we'll be looking at this for about 2020. And we'll wait with bated breath. It does look very nifty. And it's nice to see the damage being shown to great effect there by Surround. Piccolo continues on his way, 1.3 clear of Casa now. Once again, four attempts faster actually last time round was Piccolo over Casa. Fastest laps though, Piccolo has done a lap one temp faster than Casa, and those two are four attempts clear of Gene T and Wackenbauer. And once again, Rowan versus Roland. Goes for the outside. Is that going to work? He's going to end up with no road to go round. Oh, he's going to try it round the outside. That's going to be a fantastic move if he's able to pull that off. He stays well clear of Sebastian, and through he goes. Yoink, I think is the word for that. Good move there by Roland, up into fifth position. Sebastian gave him plenty of room. Respectful driving there by Seb. although he will go down to 6th position just for now. And well, Roland didn't look like he had this kind of pace in qualifying. Where has it come from? Because now he's sitting in a rather meaty 5th position. And that will do him nicely indeed. Still just a 16 left. Let's see if Roland can reel in Wackenbauer, and if he can keep actually Rowan behind him, because now Rowan actually doesn't have to defend drive. Maybe he can get himself into a stride of sorts and then start to try and push himself back up the order. Pascal has now 1.6 behind, without saying 1.7 there now. So slowly, surely, catchy monkey. Alex Piccolo continues to extend his advantage at what is the 40-minute mark. As we continue on with the 16 runners and riders remaining, our retirement so far, we've got Andrzej Kronik from what was pole position, binning it several times, I think, before just thinking, do you know what? I'm not being paid. Mirko Wenzel disconnected. What's going on there? I've got Nick Rowland showing down in 7th. Was that a disconnection? No, it's a little bit of lagaroo, I think. Or has he been into the bits? Because he's suddenly in 8th now. I feel a pit stop must have come on. Or is it an off? No, it's an off. Down into turn 1. Roly-poly Roland off into the gravel, an unforced error. What a shame there for Nick Roland. And well, he done well to dig himself into the gravel. He's back going again. He's right behind Edgar Osterman, who by being calm, collected and assured, that was really difficult to say. And that looks like, oh, I thought he was going to go round again there, did Roland. But Edgar Osterman find himself in an excellent 7th position. He's done a fantastic job lapping in the 201s at the moment. So not top notch pace, but he doesn't need to, because they're all falling by the wayside, desperately trying to throwing the race for themselves. So we shall see how they get on. Roland has the pace, but he does seem to like a little bit of off-road action. That for the first time allows Sebastian Rowan to actually be alone. I want to be alone. And Kassa now over 2 seconds behind Piccolo as they cross the line. So that's the largest that gap has ever been. So I say probably the only thing that's going now is Roland passes Osterman, but he's already gone through. Edgar Osterman down to 8th position. I don't think he'll fight that one too hard, because I think he knows that they're on slightly different levels of pace. And Edgar is already doing a fantastic job in 7th position. I think he'd be quite happy to keep that, although he's gone in a little bit deep there. A little bit deep dish pizza. Got himself back going again, and if he just needs to keep himself calm, collected, he is, because he's got what, 11 seconds over Carsten Fischer already, with Fabio Cavioli is in 10th position, having started from the very back of the grid, so he's done an excellent job himself too. So, for those of you in the chat room, I'd love to see exactly what everyone is up to for New Year. And if you had a good Christmas, and if you've got any good stories, please feel free to pop it onto the chat box so I can read it out to everyone in the broadcast. There's thousands of us all watching. Interesting to see that the sway of opinion in the chat room is that Petacasa is the strongest. There's Cagioli. He's got himself quite up nice and hot behind. Who is that? That is Carsten Fischer, surely, isn't it? As they cross the line, yep, 9th and 10th positions, looking very swish indeed. Here comes Fabio down into turn 1. What can he do on Carsten? Not a lot. Fischer continues to hold into 9th spot. Cagioli started at the back of the grid. Slowly picking drivers off as he's ascended up the order. He now quite fancies a single digit position. That Wise. See Fischer taking unnecessarily defensive tight lines into some of these corners that aren't really overtaking manoeuvres places really. So he's just losing time hand over fist, and you can see the already pitted Siggy Schroen in 11th position just reeling the pair of them in, and he wants to leapfrog the pair of them immediately. So a real split on strategy it seems then, because we're coming up to the 45 minute mark, which is bang on halfway. Some people have pitted and are two stopping. Others appear to be quite firmly in the one-stop route, which include both of our leaders, Piccolo and Casa, and third-placed man Kenneth Genty, all on his own. Or Genty, sorry. Gianti. Oh, this is on a postcard. And there you can see Schroen on the back of Fabio. This could be very tricky because they've all got the same livery. They remind me, they look slightly Sarto-ish. And look at that for a move! That is just making poor, okay. Fabio is in, as is, who was that? Roland pitting as well from 8th position. But, well, I was going to say, he just made him look like a moose. But he's come into the pit. Also in is Carmen Fischer, and that couldn't have been timed better there for Siggy, because that means, oh, have we got, is that people queuing? No, it's not. It looked like it for a split second there. I was going to say there's only 16 people left. That would be really cruel if you still had to queue behind someone. But through they all continue, and down the order these do go. That's popped Kai Matt up into 10th position behind Jörg Langen. You can see Roland rejoining in 12th position, right in front of... Who is that? That's Razak. Andreas in 15th position, so Roland there doing well to hold that one off. Piccolo and Casa continue round, Gianti locking up all kinds of brake dust. And he's our first top guy to pit. So he slots in from third position. And they're all coming in now. I think they're all taking each other's lead. So here goes Martin Palm. There's That could well cause a problem if that's exactly what Martin Palm is seeing. Suspiciously on the walk. Colo Casa. Is that into third? That's Wackenbauer. Palm then four. Gianti's rejoined in fifth. sixth, just behind Edgar Osterman, who's not pitted. Jens, who's back out in sixth, ahead of Rowan. And Siggy Schroener. So Rowan looks like he's been able to keep Schroen at bay, potentially. No, he's not, actually. I think as they're just sorting themselves out, they were all crossing the line as they were coming out of the pits. So, I'm sure that will shake itself back out again. Still 16 runners and riders remaining. I've had enough drinks that I could actually just quietly snooze on the couch. Like a little pussycat. There's a... Who's that into the pits? That's Kai Matt is in from 11th position, and here comes race leader Piccolo as well. So that's going to hand the lead to Casa. Indeed it does. So let's play compare the meerkat of the times at the pit stops to see exactly what Piccolo is up to. Who's that also? Oh, that is who's that out? Oh, Wackenbauer is out from 6th position. What's happened to him? As he's sopping down the order, he's now already down to 9th. Well, it says... that's a shame there. Ooh! Well, that makes no sense. As there is Piccolo. What's he gone? Toilet break. This is a nut stop. What is going on? Petter Kessa continues on. Palm is in too. As is Ulsterman. And he's... Oh, he smacks the back of Martin Palm. That has just been the most dodgiest exit that I've seen. A 1:06. His front splitter is laying across the pathway there. And Piccolo rejoins in what is now 6th position, minus a front splitter. What a disaster. So Cody stays in 7th position. Here comes Palm rejoining in 9th. Well, the rear not looking too disastrous, but Kai Matt has also just retired as well, so I'm wondering if that's been more problems for him from... Well, he's showing 14th at the moment, but he's out now. So, more drama on track. We saw him pop into the pits. Maybe that just lost him his connection out. Someone else is in there. It's Petter Kessa from the lead in the pits. So, we're aiming for less than 1:06. Would be good. I challenge everyone to at least 10 catchy uppies before he leaves the garage. Go. You lose. 49 seconds. Well, he was only 2 behind. I think he may well have done that as he rejoins the track in what is going to be the lead. Indeed he does. So, let's have a little looky. Siggy Schloen, who has pitted, leads. From Jörg Langen, second, who has not pitted. Third is Petter Kessa, who has. Schloen, our race leader, will have to pit again, whereas no one else, the people that just pitted won't. So, Langen has not pitted at all, needs to pit. Third is going to be Petter Kessa, who has pitted. Fourth is Kenneth Genty, fifth is Thomas Pash, who I think needs the pit again. He's jumped up the order. Sebastian Rowan is sixth. Nick Rowland, 7th. Martin Palm, 8th. Alex Piccolo is showing 9th. He's showing back in the pits again. Is Piccolo in 10th position now. Yeah, he's got a new splitter on, so he's obviously coming for repairs. And well, not content with having a problematical qualification race, he's now been robbed of victory in the pit lane here. So obviously the Pied Piper does not play a Piccolo. As Siggy crosses the line. The gap between himself and Jörg Langen now 4.5 seconds. Cass is just a further two behind Langen and closing. Oh, actually didn't close that lap because that was an outlap, but he has been faster in the long run. His fastest lap is 1.7 seconds faster than Jörg. So he's closing up quite nicely, and there we have it on your screen. Still 14 cars remaining now. So you can see a slightly scary onboard shot there. Ooh, that's not quite the racing line there, Jörg. Straight away under pressure. Of course, his tyres are very, very broken. Kassa there just flashes him through and says, thank you very much, I'll have that. Said, I'll have second position for now, so long as that gives me the win later. Tar very muchly. And Jörg knows, I think, that he's not really battling him. He's just content to do his own race. So, Kassa and Langen continue on their way. Ginty then is in fourth. It's closed in time-wise over Kassa. Not by much, still the gap 9 seconds. Thomas Pash is in fifth. Sebastian Rowan, sixth. Nick Rowland is seventh. Shady Beaver, eighth. Martin Palm. Didn't see, he's not come back in actually for anything. So he's continuing on ninth. Esther Osterman, that's not good. Edgar Osterman, I've just turned all the people into women. 10th, Alexandra Piccolo. Fabio Cangioli in 11th position. Fabiana. And then we've got a battle for the Wooden Spoon. Behind Andreas Rozak in 12th, it's Kai Chizhok, Kai Chizhoki versus Carsten Fischer. For Wooden Spoon honours, Chizhoki there is about to be absolutely murdered though, because Fischer has got his fillets out and he's going through down into turn one. And indeed he does, a nice decisive clean cut move there by Carsten, moving him up into 13th position. He's in recovery mode because he's made one more pit stop than everyone else, that was his second stop. Moves himself into 13th, he now will be fine to the finish, unless he forgot that he's got a 33 minute stint as opposed to the 30, in which case he might have to do a quick splash and dash. And that's put Kai down to the 14th position. A little bit of lag getting us all excited. So, no one's popped in the chat room. What have they done for Christmas yet? I'm getting a little bit scared, guys. Or what you're doing for New Year. So I'm assuming that you're all having a day at home with your racing games. Carl Williams has popped down that he's getting very drunk. I'll have a drink to that. We've got half an hour, no one's particularly battling each other. I'm sure I could ramble on, drunkardly. Cheers, chat. What's everyone else up to? Pop your comments in. Who is JC, actually? As there is a little bit of action going on out on track. Don't get too excited, everyone. Who's that? That is Petter Kasser. Who's he fumbling about with? It's with Siggy Schroen for the lead. Lap 28. Half an hour still left to go. Fresh tyres versus Siggy, who's going to be coming in for his second stop anytime soon anyway. He's done very well to get back into the lead, actually, has Siggy. I wonder if he's going to pull off this very lap. If he does, he might find himself slightly bulked, actually, by Kasser. I think he just wants to lead for even longer. Kasser slinking up in the slipstream. He's going to pull out and have a go down into turn one. Siggy goes and covers the line. That was a last-minute chop there. A little bit cheeky by Siggy. But if you've got a first name like that, then you should expect the unexpected, because they've obviously named him with an eye on the end to try and keep him edgy and cool. Down into turn two, and let's see what Petter, who's also spelt his name slightly wrong, would try and do. Not a lot, there's not much he can do. Into the pits comes Jörg Langen from fourth position, so he finally makes his one and only pit stop of the race. And Siggy finally lets Petter through. I think he knows that he's just not really racing him really in real life, well, or in sim racing life either, to be fair, because they're on different strategies entirely. So Kasser regains the lead that has been handed to him by Alex Piccolo, basically having a weekend long pit stop and then crashing into someone on the exit. In one of those moments where it probably seems perfectly fine at the time, and you think, why on earth was that car there in the pit lane stationary having a pit stop? How dare they? But actually, when you look back on a replay, you do those like face palm moments. A bit like Coulthard at Adelaide into the pit lane barrier. Or spinning off on the formation lap on Monza. I'm sure we could pick out all kinds of wondrous things. Oh, I've not picked up the F1 DVD yet. It's so expensive in HMV. I was like, no, I'm buying that online. So I'm waiting for it to arrive. I did notice on the box, though, that it's been slimmed down from 2-disc DVD to a 1-disc DVD. Is that just purely because there is no battle for the lead at all in any of the rounds? So, we shall remain to be seen what's going on there. I'm interested to see what everyone in the chat room weighs in on this. Who's in there? That's Thomas Paschen from fifth position. He's in for his second and final stop. No one now who pit should pit again. How much percent alcohol is this? My lips have gone. Ooh. 27. I've nearly done the bottom. I'm quite proud. Pasha rejoins in 10th place. Or so it says. trust of all time, or lifetime heat. So the only aids that have been permitted in this race is auto clutch and auto shift. The track temperature is 34.4 degrees C. That's been relatively constant throughout the event. There's Cangioli in 11th position. He's got half a minute either way between Pash and Rozak, so he's very much all on his ownsome as Kazza does a fastest lap, a 1:58.290. That has... I don't see why that is the fastest lap, because actually it says on live timing that Koning done a 1:58.134 as Siggy Schoenen is in from third position from the pits. Ah, there we go, sorry, 58.032, sorry, my bad, I was looking at the wrong thing. Story of my life. Martin Palm just doing his fastest lap of the race at 1:59.082, unfortunately he's a second off the base, and 53 seconds off the lead on lap 31. So, struggle wuggle woo. Still 14 guys left, with Kai Chigozgi last. Still 11 seconds behind Carsten Fischer. Everyone pretty much spread out. The closest thing that we've got on track really is the battle for third between Siggy Schroen and Sebastian Rowan, who have still yet to separate themselves after all of those pit stops. And the other battle that we've got kind of on our hands is Jürgen Langen and Martin Palm in the battle for 6th and 7th. So, Siggy Schroen, now that he's done his two pit stops, he's got fresh tyres, so potentially he could have a go. Sebastian there just taking a little peeky-boo. Nothing doing there though. And whoa, what on earth is Siggy doing? Siggy feeling the need to go extraordinarily defensive there into the turn. Never a good look. That's kind of my tactic. Break in a diagonal line, because then no one ever quite knows exactly where you're going. And then they think, oh, you know what, we're not even going to attempt that. And then they run off somewhere else. Works every time, unless you hit them. So, 50-50 really. But... and here you can see Nick Rowland popping up in the background there. These three, they were toe-to-toe earlier on. Toe-to-toe again. Martin Palmer's passed Jürgen Langen for 6th and 7th position, so that battle is sorted already. Langen actually has been off the track, I think, because he's dropped quite a long way behind. So that one may have been resulted... or came to a result through Gondat. So Palm all on his own now in 6th position. Let's see what the battle, the sole battle really that's left on track. You can see Rowland closing back in as well. Once again, Siggy feeling the need to go defensive into specific corners is a little bit, it's not a liability, but it's just that it's not going to help him at all by doing those kind of moves, because it's just going to lose him any of the tyre advantage that he had. And now you can see actually by the fact that it's kind of pushed Rowan into Nick Rowland. It's not going to really help him out long term. As they come over the line, turn one does seem to be the primed and tickled opportunity, and here is Nick Rowland, probably looking as close as he has been so far the last couple of laps. Once again, Siggy going defensive, and that's going to run him out wide, and that could very well allow Sebastian another run back through again. God's sake, don't take each other out, or otherwise I might feel like I need to hang myself. As we all come across for turn two, Sebastian having another look. We should go and ask himself to be signed up to Red Bull. They seem to have an affinity with that name. As they come round the next couple of corners, all very similar paced, as Rowland now is the man that looks like he wants to take a peeky boo. And Siggy crossing over in the braking zone there, looking very, very desperate to keep these two behind him. It's looking a little bit of desperation. Contact between Sebastian and there's all contact, and round they both go. Sebastian keeps it going in a straight line. Rowland is taken off by the spinning round Schroen. He's got a puncture. There's all kinds of stuff appealing everywhere. Here is the replay. Now you can see it all started off from Siggy basically taking an obscure line in after cutting across under braking. Sebastian smacks the back. He gets a puncture. There's nowhere else for him to go. Round he goes. Rowland innocently ploughs into the back. And wow, that is drama on a stick, because around plods poor old Schroen. Rowland stays in fourth, but yeah, such the tiniest of taps and pop goes the weasels, your tyre deflates, drama all round, never ever ever good. Palm then suddenly finds himself in that ugly beast of a mongrel fifth position. Who designed that car? I don't mean in the mod, but just as a car, it just looks awful. No. Yeah, enough of that. Enough of that monstrosity on the screen making my eyes bleed. Sorry, Martin, you're a great guy and you're a great driver, but that car is awful. I wouldn't have it at my dinner table. So, Rowan and Rowland now separated by a couple of seconds. I don't think that battle is over until it's over. I have to get a fat lady. If I could make her sing, that'd be quite nice. And we have another battle as Piccolo continues to try and ascend himself up the order. Who's he got poking around just in front of him? Oh, Siggy Schroner has retired from 11th position after all that. Tried to get himself back to the pits, he's out. So we're now down to 12 because Carsten Fischer has also retired a couple of last lap too, as Piccolo nearly loses it round one of these twisty corners. They're all twisty in a corner, but that's a twisty corner. It's now the battle for 7th and 8th between Edgar Osterman, and Alex Piccolo. Yeah, the most unluckiest man this evening, it must be said. We must be related. Mm-hmm. climbs the top of the hill. Who we got doing what? Not a lot for Piccolo. So while these two continue to battle on, just waiting for Kai Chikosugi to pass Siggy Schrow, and yet he does, so we now are really down to just 12 left as Fischer and Schrow have retired. Piccolo once again sizing up Ulsterman. They're reeling in Jörg Langen quite quickly. Piccolo has stopped twice, of course. Once was scheduled, and once was to repair the damage that he got, as that says Pesh is out from 10th position. That can't be right. He is! Has he run out of fuel or something? Oh dear, Thomas! Oh, maybe not. He is out! Well, that could be a number of anythings. That could be lag, blowing the fuel. Running out of fuel or blowing the engine. And then he's got a puncture, and then he's buggered, and then you just think, oh dear. So, 11 left. Legs 11. Come on, guys. Got some left. By the time. So. Martin Palm now in fourth position, Nick Rowland is third. Who else has changed position? That is just everyone sorting out. But there is Jörg Langen, now closed down by Edgar Ulsterman and Alex Piccolo, those two battling. And look at Piccolo, he's going to go for an opportunistic move down the inside. There's contact between the two! And oh, dearie me. It's worked. I don't think Edgar will be pleased with that one, or particularly Alex, because he's been in the wars already today. But I think he's got to the point where he just doesn't care, and through he's going regardless. That was a good move. That I didn't see that one coming until it was there, placed on my lap like a kind of birthday present. When I've had a few drinks, all these accents just start coming out, and none of them are very good, and none of them really deserve to be aired, so I apologise to everyone's ears in advance. Next up then, on Piccolo's list is Jörg Langen. There's Kai Chikosugi now, is up into 11th position. Two laps down, as is Andreas Rozak in 10th. Both doing solid jobs. They're still going, unlike the countless other people that have not continued the event. So a real rate of attrition. And if anything, actually, Piccolo is looking more under pressure from behind than putting pressure on ahead as they come out of the final turn. 13 minutes left to go. We are getting there. Thank you for staying with us. Here comes Piccolo. Too far back. Langen gives him too much room there. That is just like giving an open door and saying, come on through, waving a flag while you're at it. You might as well have just offered cheesy nibbles. But it's not worked out because Piccolo has had to do that. And look at that. Ulsterman says, I'll do the switcheroo back on you. Piccolo's having none of it. He'd done that move last time round. Well, that's not worked at all for either of them, because it now means that they're busy battling each other. Through goes Ulsterman again. That's going to be too close to call. We saw this earlier on with Rowan and Schroen and Bowen and Moen and Woen and Woen and Woen and Woen and Woen. And it just looked like half opportunistic moves that just you looked at it and you just thought crash. Because it just doesn't look realistic, and you can just see that like the trajectories of where the cars are going is going to be carbon fiber. Now though, Here comes Golo. Once again, given a very, very tiny advantage now. And you can see, once he's not having to look in his mirrors, he just swarms back in on Jörg Langen, who is running a few minutes slower. Sebastian Rowan has done a 2:06 and has dropped behind Martin Palm. So he's obviously had an excursion somewhere. So he won't be pleased with that. Langen feeling the need to try and drop off the slipstream right at the beginning of that straight. 11 minutes left to run. Oh, through he tries again. What on earth is going on there? Because Piccolo has gone from being aggressive to being horrifically defensive. Osterman desperately trying to find a way back through to regain his seventh position, and indeed he has done. Piccolo, down to eight he doth go. And let's see what Osterman can do again, because he seems to have been able to pick off Piccolo. Seems to be already sizing up. Jörg Langen ahead. Sorry, I was desperately trying to mask that yawn, but it's been a very long drunken day. And I have drunk too much, so I apologise for my general sloppiness on the broadcast. But it's Christmas, no one told. Well, I think I agreed to this when I was last drunk, because I came home from work and thought, oh, what's all this about me broadcasting in 10 minutes time? I've not even had a key yet. Let's look at Osterman there, right onto the back of Langen. Start finish straight, and he's sizing himself up. Langen's going to go defensive, or is he not? No, he's no, because Osterman is going to dive through regardless. My goodness, give him... I could get a whole trailer sideways through that gap. It's the kind of gaps that you see in... Well, actually, I won't finish that. It's up into sixth position goes Edgar. Well, I was cheering him on earlier on, saying that he was doing fantastically well in seventh. Now, all of a sudden, Piccolo's fancying a nose through as well, and they're neither of them particularly on the racing line. They're going to make contact, and Piccolo spins round once again. It's not working out at all for Alex. He's kept going again. Well done. No rage quitting for you, my friend. That deserves an alcoholic salute, actually. That's there we go. Drink the dregs. So Kasser is still leading. Kenneth Jeansey is still in second. Not that we've seen anything of him, because he's been such a silent squirrel. He just got on with it. Nick Rowland is in third place currently at the moment. Martin Palm still sitting in fourth, but closing down Rowland. Fifth is Sebastian Rowan. So we have a cop cam. I don't know what that is. Parrot cam? I don't know. Oh, not even that. There we go. Oh. Like Christmas. When you open up your present and you find that the DVDs are Region 1. Bubba. Or it's staring. It's a very fine lady. And yeah, that's true, actually. Even that car is so ugly, not even the cameras want to look at it. As Kai Chigoski is in the pits from 11th position, someone's forgot to fuel their car up. And what is he doing there? Is he overshot? Yeah, reverse-a-roo, that's not going to work at all. I don't quite know what he's up to. In fact, I think he's just... Well, who knows? He's done so far. You can't quit now, Kai. Come on. So, not quite sure what's going on there. Kaza continues on. Jinty then. Roland. Palm is fourth position. Stop putting that car on the screen. I'm going to vomit. Fifth, Sebastian Rowan. Sixth, Edgar Osten. Seven, Jörg Langen. Eighth, Alex Piccolo, recovered from a spin now. Ninth is Fabio Cangioli. Blue sky thing here. 10th is Andreas Rosowski. Oh my god. Was that the camera or was that just me epileptic fitting on alcohol? Seriously. That reminds me of one time at band camp. 11th. I'm not sure if he actually did pit in the end. He's now nearly 7 minutes actually off the leader. Oh, he's got... Oh, dear. What's Kai up to? Well, look. It's got... I don't think the wheel went on. Oh, maybe that's why he reversed back. He's like, where's my wheels? Well, it's these little nuances and these little quirks that make you just love R Factor that little bit more than every other sim racing game that's going on in the world. Especially now that he's in reverse. Ah. Reminds me of when you go searching for a fallopian tube when you do a replay, because eventually you get to a point where you just think, it's gone too far back, pull back, pull back. Everyone's trying to get out before they've sown the seed. Mervnik Roland on your screen, still holding up third position. He's got a second over Palm and the ugly spider. Got how many minutes? 4 left. 4 minutes left. 4 minutes. 4 life-size minutes. I'm sure 4 midget-sized minutes would be exactly the same length of time. I'm loving the fact there is a good debate over what good vodka is in the chat room. JC, you must join us more often. It's been a pleasure having you all in the chat box with us. I hope at least if my commentary ramblings, drunkard as they have been, and nonsensical as they always have been, the day I came out of that womb I thought, well, can I go back in please? It's nice and warm. Ooh, slide-a-roo from Roland. Doesn't want to do that. Looks lovely, but unfortunately doesn't help you time-wise. I hope at least this has given you an impression of the GT3 mod that we've been busy showcasing this evening with this hugely popular event. It's been quite a while since I've actually... been able to... Is that real? Can't be. Oh no, I meant what was going on in the chat. Anyway, right, so you're only hearing one part of the conversation. I was like... Tinned pussy, Kyle. Well, maybe you do. That might be the only one you get. So, as we move forward to the last 2 minutes, I hope this has given you a insight into the GT3 mod. It is in beta testing still, or beta testing, depending on where you come from and what kind of disgusting vileness you think. Oh dear. The tone has gone down in my ears here. See, this is why you need to be part of the interactive element. Interactivity all the way. Otherwise, because if you were with us, you'd just be eating a dinner of fish fingers right now. But is that the clock striking zero? Have we got another minute? Oh, I've got another minute left to go. By the look of it, so I suppose we better go and find who's the leader these days. Is it still Casa? Kitty Casa. Hopping round his second to last lap because he's not going to be able to slow down enough to cross the line without having to... he's going to have to cross the line before the time hits zero. Which indeed he will. He says in hope. Yes, he does. So we've got one more lap left with Peter Casa. This GT3 mod is still in testing, of course, so it's going to be released pretty soon as a lovely little swan song for R Factor before R Factor 2 regurgitates itself onto our PCs in the near future, we hope. We're hearing that there's still stuff to be added to it all the time, so maybe 2013 is looking good. yeah. 2013 as opposed to 2012, because every time they want to add something to it, we know it's going to delay at least another 6 months. But when you have a sim that gives you such fun as Disconnections, Wheels, I was going to say Loose Wheels, that reminds me of that program Loose Women, they need to be shot. Seriously, what is that program all about? Maybe we should just have Loose Men. It's just... Loose Men, what would we do? What would happen on that show? People just romp around and go, it actually is just Top Gear, but for lunchtime. Although... I don't even want to repeat what's been going on in chat room and in my ears. My poor little things. Who's that? Looking a little bit worse for wear. Is Casa nearly been taken out on the last thing? Is that Piccolo? Piccolo's retired from 10th position. I think he's collected Chikowski, who is really plodding round with a broken wheel. So Piccolo out on the very last lap. Oh dear, what an absolute disaster. Casa is busy serenading his way through. He didn't have it all his own way, but Alex Piccolo decided that luck was not going to be his lady today, and a very pleased Peter Casa wins here for the GT3 demonstration. Second will be Kenneth GNT, who deserves many, many rounds of applause for being second. 17 seconds off the pace, 18 now as he crosses the line. Well done to Kenneth. Third, potentially, with no more dramas happening, will be Nick Rowland, who from right the way down the further end of the grid has actually done a very, very good drive to get himself up the order. And he will potentially cross the line to be third. Second is Martin... Fourth will be Martin Palm. Fifth will be Sebastian Rowan. There's Palm in fourth position. Sebastian Rowan in fifth position. My eyes! Is going to bring home Edgar Ulsterman. Ulsterman there unable to grab a top five position in the end, but he's done so well to claw it.